the product that we are working towards developing would be the first tissue-engineered brain pathways. So these pathways are really the most crucial component for the higher cognitive function in humans. So the brain, being clusters of neurons on the outer layer, and then there's other populations of neurons deep in, you can think of these as specialized processing centers. But the exquisite processing capability of the human brain arises from these crisscrossing connections that allow information to be separated, processed as units, and then recombined where it needs to. So these processes that are connecting the brain, you can think of them as the fiber optic cables between different processing units, and the processing units are populations of neurons. So when these fiber optic cables go, and they can be vulnerable in traumatic brain injury, stroke, or neurodegenerative disorders like Parkinson's disease, there's really no way to get these pathways or cables back.
What other treatments have looked at doing are basically trying to replace the dopamine that's lost in the brain. They're trying to stimulate it to release more, which works for some time and works for some patients. However, at one point, the brain will no longer have any of these dopamine neurons. And if they don't have the neurons to secrete dopamine, the drugs don't work anymore. So you need to replace the entire dopamine secreting neuron factories. What some solutions do, they actually try and drop these dopamine factories in one area of the brain, but they don't have the controls that are found deeper in the brain. So we actually place the structures where it should be and reaching the targets where it's supposed to be. So we've actually replaced the entire pathway.
One of the things that I believe is trickiest about neural tissue engineering is that you're working with living cells, and neurons in particular are a pretty finicky cell type. They just need an excuse to die, and you know your experiment is ruined. Before you even get to the point where you're testing hypotheses and seeing, you know, the functionality of the constructs, you have to get them to survive long term and mature in the way that they're supposed to.
Because they form during embryogenesis, when target and source were relatively close in proximity, and as the brain expands up into adulthood, the distances of these pathways really become insurmountable for regeneration. So as a tissue engineer approaching the problem of repairing the injured brain, really the holy grail is being able to put back these long distance pathways. And there's been much effort over many decades to coax nerve cells to regenerate these long distances. And unfortunately, those efforts haven't been successful. So our approach is to create these pathways outside the body, but in an implantable form factor, and then microinject them as a unit to precisely reconnect discrete parts of the brain and put the pathway back that way.